This is part 27 of Azure tutorial. In our previous video, we discussed deployment slots, how to create and their use. In this video, we'll discuss what happens to application configuration settings, such as a database connection string, for example, when we swap deployment slots in Azure. Now, let's say we have two deployment slots, staging and production. Staging slot points to the staging database and production slot points to the production database. I have the exact scenario set up. At the moment, as you can see, we have two deployment slots, production and staging. What I've done so far is deployed the same version of the app in both the slots. On the left, we have our production URL. We can say that because in the URL, we don't see the word staging. And on the right here, we have our staging URL. Again, we can say that because we see the word staging in the URL. Now, our application in the staging deployment slot is pointing to the staging database, and our application in the production deployment slot is pointing to the production database. If we take a look at the Azure portal, notice we have two databases, production DB and staging DB. Our production deployment slot is pointing to the production DB and staging deployment slot to the staging DB. Now, both the databases, that is production and staging, have the same data. So by looking at the UI, we can't really say the difference. We can't say which version of the app is pointing to which database. So if you look at our production version on the left, we have the same 5 rows. And if we take a look at the staging version on the right, again, the same 5 rows. So to have some difference, let's insert a new row into our production database table. And I'm going to do that from SQL Server Management Studio. So we have a query here, and we are inserting a new row into our quotes table in the production database. So let's execute this query. Notice now our production version of the app is displaying the new row that we have just inserted into the production database, whereas our staging version of the app is still displaying the same old 5 rows. Now, let's also make a change to our application code. At the moment, we are displaying the author name just below the code on the left-hand side. Let's change it to display on the right-hand side. The change itself is pretty straightforward. All we have to do is change the text alignment to right in both the item template and alternating item template. Now, let's deploy this changed version of our application in the staging deployment slot, so we have the opportunity to test everything and make sure the app works as expected. So let's go to the publish page, and notice in the drop-down list here, we have our staging deployment slot selected. Let's publish the changes. Notice now on the staging version of the app, we have the author name displayed on the right-hand side as expected. And we can still say our staging version of the app is pointing to the staging database because we only see those 5 rows. We don't see that new row we have just inserted into the production database. And whereas if we take a look at our production version of the app, we have the author name still displayed on the left-hand side. And this version of the app is pointing to the production DB because we see the code from the production database. Now, let's say we are happy with our testing and we want to promote this staging build to production. We do that in Azure by swapping the deployment slots, staging to production and production to staging. In the Azure portal, we are on the deployment slots page and we see both our slots, production and staging. We want to swap them. So let's click this swap button. Remember, we are swapping staging into production and production into staging. So the source slot is staging and the target slot is production. And take a look at the config changes here. At the moment, we have source changes selected and our source is our staging slot. And here is our database connection string. When we are swapping these slots, the database connection string is also being swapped. Notice we have old value and new value. New value is the one we get after swap. At the moment, we know our source slot, that is our staging slot, is pointing to the staging DB. We can see that when I hover the mouse over the connection string here. Notice initial catalog, it is pointing to staging DB. After the swap, we get this new value. And notice, after swap, our staging slot is pointing to production DB. And this is definitely not the behavior we want. And the same is true even for the target slot. Our target slot now is production. At the moment, we know our production slot is pointing to the production DB. Again, we can see that from the connection string here. But after swap, our production slot will be pointing to staging DB. This is not the behavior we want. Let's actually see this in action. Let's click this swap button. There we go. Swap complete. Our staging version of the app is successfully promoted to production. We can say that by looking at our production URL. Notice now the author name is displayed on the right hand side as expected. So our build is definitely promoted to production. But then take a look at the data that we have on our production version of the app. We don't see that new row we have inserted in the production database. This means our production version of the app is now pointing to the staging database. This is definitely not the behavior we want. We want the production version of the app to always be pointing to the production database. Take a look at the staging version on the right hand side. We see here the quote from the production database. So our staging database is pointing to the production database. So upon swapping the slots, by default, along with the build, our application configuration settings. In this case, we have only one setting, and that is the database connection string. This database connection string is also swapped. And this is the reason our production slot is now pointing to the staging database, and the staging slot is pointing to the production database. We don't want this to happen. Even after the swap, production slot should be pointing to the production database, and staging slot should be pointing to the staging database. So we basically want the database connection string to stick with its respective slot. We don't want it to be swappable. This is very easy to achieve. All we have to do is mark the database connection string setting as a deployment slot setting. First, let's swap these slots back. So our staging slot will be pointing to the staging database and the production slot will be pointing to the production database. There we go. Swap complete. Notice, now, our production version on the left is pointing to the production database. We can say that because we can see that code from the production database. And our staging version on the right-hand side is pointing to the staging database. Again, we can say that because we don't see that row from the production database. And the builds are also reverted because on the staging version, we see the author name is displayed on the right-hand side. And on our production version, the author name is displayed on the left hand side. Remember, we don't want our database connection string to be swappable. We want it to stick with its respective slot. We can very easily achieve this by marking the database connection string as a deployment slot setting. And we do that on the configuration of our deployment slot. At the moment, we've got two slots. We can do that either on the production slot or the staging slot. It doesn't really matter. At the moment, we already have our production slot selected. That's why it's not clickable. So let's navigate to its configuration. So notice we have the configuration option under settings. So let's click on that. We see our application configuration settings here. And let's scroll all the way down. Our database connection string is right here. Notice the name code DB context. And let's click this edit icon. Remember, we want to mark our database connection string as a deployment slot setting. And all we have to do for that is check this checkbox, deployment slot setting, and then click OK. And very important, don't forget to click save. Let's go back to the deployment slots page. And for that, click on this deployment slots option. Let's swap the slots again. Here is the important bit. Notice under config changes, we don't have any changes. This means our database connection strings are not being swapped. Let's actually see this in action by swapping these two slots. There we go. Swap complete. Notice now the author name is displayed on the right hand side on our production version. So our staging build is definitely promoted to production, and this production version is still pointing to the production database. We can say that because we see that row from the production database. And on the right, we have our staging version. We see the author name on the left-hand side, and we don't see that row from the production database. So this means our staging version is still pointing to the staging database. So here's the important point to keep in mind. If you want to make your application configuration settings stick with the respective deployment slot, then mark all those configuration settings as deployment slot settings. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.